have to approach?
That's saying the least, yeah. Difficult is definitely something that describes Eichenwald here. I mean, the fact that defense have such an advantage and getting through the doorway where you have these tight choke points, you have two avenues to actually push through and they kind of focus you into a tight area. It's just, it's proven to be really difficult for even the best of teams. So I really wonder if we're even going to get that far on the map.
All right, well, let's go ahead and see if Rogue can fire back, make this a five-game set, or if this is just going to be a nice closeout for LW Red. Let's get into our fourth and potentially final map. Here we are. Welcome to Eichenwald. Is it Eichenwald or Eichenwald?
It depends where you're from, right? So if you're in America, it's like Eichenwald. Eichenwald. If you're in Germany, it's Eichenwald, because the E always has like a hard sound. You always pronounce the E in German. I don't know. The announcer says something different. Everyone says something different. All we know is everyone can agree on it's a really difficult map to attack on.
I'll just stick with Eichenwald. Yeah, it's as difficult to attack as it is to say correctly, I suppose.
I agree. But speaking of attacking, it's going to be Luxroach Red on the attack here, and it looks like they want to go for a similar composition that they've been running, really aggressive with the Genji Tracer. You have the D.Va and the Winston to jump in. And they don't have really a Meiwald to worry about too much, so there is always the potential for them to pretty much all jump over this right-hand side that you're seeing on your screen, but most likely they're going to have to push through the choke point to really do some work here.
And that's really shocking to see that Rogue is not going to be running a Mei on this. I mean, every time we've seen Eichenwald so far, it has been a Mei coming in, trying to get those isolated picks onto a member of the attacking crew. But Rogue going to go with a bit of a different approach here with this triple tank. So we'll see if it's going to be able to, or the quad tank rather, and see if this is going to be able to pay off. They're really fond of this strat, I suppose. LW Red already just pushing forward. You can see how far back Rogue has to play.
Yeah, they don't really have the healing to actually combat and kind of take some damage and heal it right back up. It's going to be a little bit difficult, but it does mean Unko gets a lot more nano boosts off because of how many targets he can actually heal. It's just whether or not he can do it. And Nanohana, he hooked in right away, but he somehow survives.
Yeah, that's going to be a really nice deflect coming through, keeping himself alive with the help of Luna. Maybe he'll be going into the back line, trying to get on AKM, is able to take him out, and this is going to be Unko maybe going down as well as he just keeps chasing him through. Can't pick up that health back though. Couple more shots. But
he stole it!
Oh, but he's actually able to snap back. Won't be finding Unko quite yet, but Nanohana, he's coming through. He's going to join the party. Actually able to get the deflection kill onto Nox, taking him out. And LW Red moving straight in onto this first point. Looks like they may be able to take this one. Dragon Blade ready, but they don't even have to burn it to cap this one. And now they're going to start moving that payload.
Because the DPS and the tanks went like behind the point, they forgot about, hey, we're actually losing the point here during this one. We're trying to actually defend AKM, who kind of got pushed out and caught off guard a little bit. And this really aggressive composition of Luxroach Red, it played a little bit differently, worked out flawlessly. And now they have the high ground control, at least for now, but Jonas is going to have to back away very, very soon. And we'll just lead back towards his team. But really well done. And this Dragon Blade and Pulse Bomb combo with Janus jumping in with Primal Rage can just completely demolish them on this high ground position.
Yeah, that's going to be about four ultimates available here in just a second. There it is. Janus has it. Gambler just a little ways away from that down barrier. Sabiobi able to drop the Pulse Bomb. Fights two. Takes out AKM and Skipjack despite the shield from Winston. Drops it right inside. And Sabiobi is just popping off on the Tracer, going to the back line and just absolutely shredding through Rogue.
So Rogue will have another chance. But Luxroach Red, they only use two ultimates in that fight. They're going to have Sound Barrier up soon. They have the Transcendence as well, which is going to be really crucial. Luckily for Rogue, there's no shield or no guaranteed shield out of a Reinhardt to block Broader Grenade from coming through. But look at the position they're holding. They're trying to use this choke point against them.
And it's working out really well. Nanohana going low, trying to get an answering kill on a Skipjack as he jumps away. Soon as actually able to come in, though, and shut down that Genji finally. CLP going low, but he's going to get healed right back up. Nox goes down. Mekko finds that, and Luna takes out AKM. And that is going to be a nice push coming through from LW. All they have to do is get rid of wins, and there it is. They're going to keep things charging straight up to the gate.
Self-destruct through the sides. I mean, that can completely hold them back. Rogue's not running a Reinhardt either, so they have really nothing to guarantee protect from this unless you get a good timing on that shield out of Skipjack. And Sabiobi just going to throw that Pulse Bomb just to buy some extra time. Even the Primal Rage being used just to keep them in there.
Oh, but that is actually going to be Sabiobi going down AKM and able to find the kill. Mekko throwing out the self-destruct, gets Nox. AKM, nano boosted, coming through, already found Janus, going to be looking for more. That's a nice headshot coming through on the Nanohana, gets Luna as well, and AKM He might just be able to hold this one all for his team. Gets Gambler, and there we go. Pretty much a solo hold coming through from him. AKM doing some work on the McCree.
So I think I know what AKM stands for now. Stands for a killing machine, because that man held on somehow by himself with some amazing shots. And it looks like finally the rest of his team, as he does fall, will be there to back him up and be able to save this checkpoint. But 3.9 meters. Was all too close.
Not where I thought you were going. I thought you were going to say ass kicking machine, which is also relevant.
I mean, that also works, yeah. I was doing the PG version.
All right, well, I'll go to the PG-13 version.
Nice.
I'll push it just a notch higher, I suppose. But a really good hold from Rogue, and now they're going to start getting that roll back on the payload. It's going to be crucial for them because LWB Red is looking like they're going to be able to sweep right through, but they got stopped dead right there. And now they don't have any ultimates to play with, and there's three on the side of Rogue.
Yeah, so actually,
make that four.
LWB Red switched up quite a few different heroes. Like Jonas, he's going to be on the Reinhardt now, so we get the Winston. Nanahana switched over from the Genji to the Soldier, which is at 81% on his ultimate. And Sabiobi is just committing to this Tracer, even a sneaky play out of Mecha there, just trying to keep the push, keep pushing the payload to catch him off guard, since no one on Rogue is really there to contest it. But Rogue have so many ultimates to use. With no deep, or they do have a deep on the side of LWB Red, but Mecha's going to have to somehow mitigate the Graviton Surge coming through, or the Deadeye, or potentially both.
Yeah, could be a bit of a rough spot for him. He gets either going to go ahead and charge right up the wall. But that's Sabiobi going down immediately. AKM, I think he finally found his number and just taking him out continuously. But LWB Red, they're just going to come right around the back and onto the payload, trying to get a little bit of a push out of it. It looks like it's going to work. That's going to be the ultimate coming through from Skip Dash, trying to push them out. Nanahana popping his as well, but the Graviton Surge sucking them all in. AKM finds Gambler, but he gets taken out. Nanahana able to just hone in onto him and knock him out of that Deadeye. But LWB Red, they still have the peel back as several members go down. Sabiobi able to find Unko, but he goes low, has to dash out. They can't stick around, and they barely gain anything on that payload push.
Sabiobi, he almost made such a clutch play, too, in that fight, because he died early on, right? But what he was trying to do was jump into the back line with his pulse bomb, which was just almost up. It was at 90%, catch up quite a few of them since they're clumped together, and then win the fight off of that. But now he's being forced to switch. He's gone over towards Roadhog because they need a little bit more pick potential, a little bit more guaranteed damage, but also a way to deal with Soon, who is starting to finally ramp up on his Tracer.
Ramp up. They're going up the ramparts here.
Too easy. Getting, too easy.
Yeah, going into that high ground. Have to be careful though. Soon has that pulse bomb ready to go. Actually just threw it out, but it wasn't able to find a target. Mecha with the self-destruct. Might have another one just as a zoning ultimate, trying to push them away from that payload so they can get back on top of it. But from Sabiobi, not going to be able to find anybody. And they're pinching back in, shoving Rogue the opposite way down the bridge. Mecha able to find Wins with the self-destruct. Hook coming through. They're going to find Unko. He goes down. LWB Red, this might be their opening to continue this push and maybe make that second checkpoint, because the clock is ticking. It's 45 seconds left.
And Sui's just trying to distract as long as he possibly can, but eventually he's going to run out of blinks. He's going to fall down from this one in Rogue. Don't really have anyone who can contest in time. It's going to be Wins trying to rush through, but he's going to have to give this one away. And LWB Red, after a hard-fought battle, will capture the second checkpoint. Now look to finish off the map.
See, looking a little bit flustered there inside the Rogue booth. Thought that they might be able to hold that one for the whole time, but now 2 minutes left on the clock for LWB Red. It's going to be a very tough push for them to get to this third and final point. And Ohana has that tack visor ready to go, but Mecha, he's actually going to go down. Wins pushed really far forward away from his team, just zoning back LW. And they'll go ahead and they'll back off. The gate's open. See if they can poke through before they move that payload, try to get a pick, and then get a hard push going.
The thing is, this actually works really well for LWB Red because the payload hasn't pushed to the door hasn't shut. So yeah, they have a lot more different avenues to actually push through this tight, closed area, which they're going to do just now. The door is going to shut. Nanahana towards the top side. They get attacked by Azure. Nana boosted, but that Reinhardt shield is going to be there to protect.
Yeah, he's right in front. Pulse Bomb coming through. Not going to be able to find Nanahana yet. And he's still just shredding through whatever members that he can find. Not able to find a kill. Just gets AKM, actually. And now that's going to be the Transcendence coming through from Unko, just trying to keep his team alive. Not a whole lot of kills coming through on the side of LWB Red. They're actually now able to pick up Wins. Trying to turn back to this fight. Skipjack throwing out that Earth Shatter. Gets a nice kill coming through with the help of Soon as they finish off Gambler. And now they're starting to trade it back. Soon dashing forward. Takes out Luna. Helps take out Mecha. And that is going to be a nice hold from Rogue.
And with how quickly LWB Red took the first point, took the fights after, got that payload to the door, you really have to give credit to Rogue to stabilize this game, because it can be very snowbally against you, and once you start getting inside of your own head and start losing fight after fight, it becomes really frustrating. So honestly, doing a great job of being able to take this one back and put up a good defense, but they have to keep this one going. They cannot let this payload to push too much further, and AKM directly behind them. These are some easy kills.
Oh boy, and that's going to be a huge pickup from Janus. He was the only member of LWB Watch that has an ultimate available, and now there's just 20 seconds left on the clock. Mecha finally gets his. because Janus will be coming up very soon. But they have to get through AKM with that Death Blossom, and it's not looking good for Luxury Watch Red. 10 seconds left on the clock. They have to push. It's now or never.
They're going to have to contest. 5 seconds left. It's going to be Mecha, the one to be on top of this one. He has his self-destruct to use. Earshatter comes through, but doesn't even connect on anyone.
Yeah, the Transcendence is there as well, so he's going to try to hold off as best as he can. Nox finding a double kill, actually. Nanohana is finally able to trade that one back onto Soon. The self-destruct there finds two kills, wins, and Umko go down. That could be a huge opening for LW Red, but the clock is now into overtime. AKM doing what he can to get through that Diva Soon, but it's not enough. Janus taking out Nox in the meantime, and this is going to be a massive push, but LW Red, they have to stick to this payload like glue. They cannot leave it, or they will lose right here.
Yeah, but I mean, Ro, they need one fight to stop this one, but looks Rush Red, they're looking really good here. Nanohana, he's already on the main. He has 70% ult built up from that last fight alone. If he could put a blizzard on top of the payload, they could finish this one off.
And they're looking to do that. So the nano boost coming through now onto Mech OC. If he can get AKM, takes him quite low. Can he finish him off? That's gonna be the question, and he does do so. Pulse bomb on the side, not gonna find a target, and that Blizzard is getting closer and closer. 80% here from Nanohana. Just needs a little bit more. Earth Shatter connects on the Gambler. And Gambler, he is going to go down. Skipjack able to swing his way to victory. But that's going to be the freeze from Nanohana. Does he find the kill? Finally, with the help of Luna, takes out Skipjack. Nox firing back will take out the Reinhardt. But this is still looking so good for Luxury Watch Red. 4 kills coming through as Rogue is trying to rush back. But there it is. Mecco yet again with the self-destruct. Finds AKM, who is trying to delay. And they will finally cap in overtime.
Oh, my lord. That last fight, AKM getting caught off. Nanohana, he ice formed, but while he was in the ice form, when he had low HP, he realized, I have Blizzard, I need to use this now. So he almost sacrificed himself by coming out of that one, popping the Blizzard down, and he actually saves Jonas's life by actually booping him up with the ice wall so he couldn't be taken down. Unfortunately for him, they still lost Gambler on the Lucio, but insane. And Soon, I think he went to the back line of that fight and tried to hit a pulse bomb onto the supports, but I think he missed it. We saw it happen relatively after AKM died, which could have obviously, you know, give them the potential hold. And now Rogue, the pressure's, it's honestly on them. They're down 2-1 in the series. They have to complete the map now. Obviously, LW Red did it in overtime, but it's so hard to finish off a map like this that they might have to go for something crazy.
I mean, this is one of the hardest payload maps to push. Rogue, they have to pull something out here. We can see maybe a Pharah in store for them. LW Red, however, gonna be running with that Mei. So they said, you know what? We pushed through you really easily because you guys didn't have a Mei. We're going to run a Mei. We're going to try to isolate your targets. We're going to just pick them off one by one as you come in.
So again, I don't want to sound too negative, but assuming Rogue go with the comp that we see on the screen, like obviously if you have the ability to put Tracer on someone,
put it on Soon.
You want to put on Soon, but maybe this is the inflexibility of some of the players.
Look
on
at
the
that
side
synergy.
Of Rogue. Because they don't have wins playing. They have him playing the Tracer, so he's obviously like he's a competent Tracer, but Soon is a Tracer specialist, which is like one step further. He's like rank S on Tracer, where Wins is gonna be like rank A. So you can, oh my gosh,
this is like one of those Russian Adidas suits like dance parties that they have.
The sensitivity. We just need the Reinhardt shield spinning, and it's a rave. But no, Rogues are switching quite a few things up here. AKM on the Pharah, Soon on the Genji. They're running the double healer, the solo tank, and they're looking to just overpower Luxury Watch Red.
If they're able to do so, it looks like they are going to go ahead and stick with AKM on this Pharah. Going to have to be really accurate, get some body shots in. He wants to come out on top. Luckily, he doesn't have to worry about a McCree or a Soldier on the side of Luxury Watch Red. You see they're actually going to go ahead and push through. Not going to be playing up on the choke with Nanohana on the Mei. Looks like they're going to be playing this the same way that Rogue had. But AKM taking a couple of those icicles to the face. He's going to have to pull back and get healed up by Gambler and Luna.
There's really no one to really take AKM out of the sky unless Sabiob hits the hook, or if somehow Nanohana hits an amazing icicle and Soon diving straight in here, just going for a couple of reflex off. And so far, they've been able to get on top of the point. They've been able to get some good progress on it. It looks like Red are forced into this tight choke point, and they're not able to pick up a kill yet.
Yeah, they almost get Sabiob, but he goes back, and he gets healed up just in time. AKM going back up into the sky, firing out into the Hunter's Lodge as best as he can, trying to get some shots in, but not really finding much. Hovering above the point, trying to get Nanohana, but he makes it into the ice block. And you can see the hook coming through. And he goes down. A nice pick by Sabiobi, just ripping him right out of the sky.
Yeah, there's a lot of pressure on this man here. Like, we heard Nanohana talking about him being their secret weapon, and he has to hit these hooks onto AKM to really eliminate that threat from the high ground. He's been able to do just that. So now, LW Red, they do have the Nanoboost available. They have the Blizzard very, very soon. So Wins is going to have to hit a really good pulse bomb to open up some sort of attack here to successfully capture the point.
Yeah, I mean, you see Soon here, 90% towards that Dragon Blade, but if there's a Blizzard on top of him, it's not going to do a whole lot of good if he gets frozen. So this could really make things tough for Rogue as they try to get onto this point. Pulse Bomb coming through, not going to find a target. Luna. He's going to go ahead and use that nano boost. It's going over onto Sabioli by the look of things. Zoom going through. He's dashing in with a help fake cam, able to find three kills. Transcendence there as well, trying to keep him alive. Heal deny coming out. Mecha throws up the self-destruct. We'll only find one. That's three members of LW dead as they now come up, but this might be the opening for Rogue. Halfway on the cap here, and I think they're going to be able to take it right here. LW Red going to pull back. Let them take this point, and this gives Rogue plenty of time to move forward.
And AKM's going to switch over, probably to Soldier most likely to use. Like the Barrage and the Dragon Blade, even though the Pulse Bomb missed, was just too much damage for LW Red to heal. They didn't really have any mitigation to stop that either. Like, the shield's not going to last too long out of your Reinhardt. So really well done by Rogue. They hit that point where they have just the ult advantage, they have the damage advantage, able to swell over LW Red. But Unko already going down, so we'll hold the push a little bit longer. But Sabio was playing really aggressive. He's playing on the ground here. He can easily get picked off by pretty much anyone. Like Unko, you discord him, and even his Zenyatta can kill him.
Yeah, he's trying to go for a hook on the wind, seeing if he's going to flank around from the side. But he can't get him yet. Wind's just going to be poking out. Has that pulse bomb ready to go yet again. That's one of three ultimates available to Rogue.
That wasn't even
there
meant
we
for
go.
Him.
That's now 30. He gets snatched up by Sabiobi. He gets taken out, though, as Nox finishes him off. See the shield coming off from LW Red, not doing a whole lot of good. Sabiobi and Janus both going down, just Mecha the last tank remaining. He's still going to push very far forward to try to zone off Rogue. They did lose a couple of their own members.
Oh, no. How do you get a sleep dart like that?
Oh, that is just absolutely dirty from Luna. Landing that one. Now you can see the nano boost coming through on the Mecha, trying to get some damage in. Build up onto that self-destruct. Not taking a whole lot, but he's not getting much done. So he'll just push himself to about 87%. Should be getting his ultimate up.
Oh,
around the same time as Anohana. Ooh, gets the hook in, but it's not enough to get the kill on the AKM. Very nicely done, but that will be the Transcendence being popped by Unko as they push forward. Nox and AKM do fall in the end. However, Soon trying to do some work, has that deflect, but it's not enough. Gets shot from behind. Anohana on the high ground, having that advantage, and they take out Unko as well. And LW Red are just going to maintain the hold right on the payload.
So we talked about with AF Blue against Lunatic High. If you don't have anyone who can contest the Soldier on the higher ground, he's just getting freely healed by everyone. You're not really ideally going to win the fight unless you somehow just completely stomp them on the ground. Sabiobi, like, the hooks he's been hitting have been, like, really, really good. The problem is he hasn't been hitting the targets he's intentionally meant for. Like, he went for a hook onto, I think it was, like, Skipjack or something, and he caught Winds on the Tracer. Getting a little bit of luck there, but he's still hitting hooks nonetheless. And on the high ground, that was Soon trying to dismantle Nanohana.
Yeah, you can see another Nanobu's coming through on the Mecha. He's down about half HP, so has that self-destruct to throw out. You can see that was a swap over from AKM onto the Reaper. And LW, they're just pushing them straight back towards the spawn. Winds as well, swapping over to the Zarya, trying to build up that ultimate as best as he can, but he's only at 16%. They have 2 minutes left. Nanohana has that ultimate. Mecha still has not had to throw out his, and they almost have another sound barrier available from Gambler.
It's Skipjack and Soon to jump on top of Nanohana, but if Luna's there to protect him, you're not going to really kill him. He's going to be able to escape from this one, and you have no one to protect your backline on the ground.
Yeah, there we go. That's going to be self-destructed. Winds gets caught out. He goes down. It's going to be a very nice pick, halting that Zarya from building up any more ultimeter. Now just trying to get onto Soon. He's going to deflect as best as he can, but that D.Va will shred right through him, so he's going to have to reject himself. Actually, nose up drop, trying to duel out here with Nanohana, but the sound barrier comes through. Transcendence is there to heal him back to full, but that's a really big shockwave coming out from the Reinhardt, charges forward, and that's just going to help LW Red continue to sweep through Rogue, finding four more kills, AKM, because you know what? The Reaper's not working. I have to go back to the Soldier.
Yeah, he definitely needs to. I think they also need a D.Va. They also need a Reinhardt here to successfully push this one. They have no one to stop Nanohana from just doing so much free damage. He's been hooded onto this tactical visor for so long. This has been 3 minutes of Rogue making zero progress.
I mean, look at that. Soon pushing too far forward. Just he goes down. Help us save Yolvi there. Nanohana picking up the kill. And this is just looking so good for LW Red. 50 seconds left on the clock, and Rogue have barely moved this payload from the spot, the start. A lot of pressure on them. Sound barrier up for Nox, but everybody else fairly far away from their ultimates. Mecha almost having another self-destruct. See, Nanohana still holding on to that. See if he wants to pop self-destruct coming through. Nox trying to run away. Looks like he may be able to make it out, and he will. No members of Rogue going down quite yet, but Nanohana gets that nano boost, but hasn't even popped the visor, so he still has that to fall back on to pump out the damage onto Rogue. There it is. Gonna go ahead and pop this now. Trying to get AKM, but he's hiding behind the bad ruin, but he's still going to get popped in on Hannah coming up with the double kills. He takes out Nox, but he will fall as Wins throws out that Graviton Surge up top, sucks in the healers, but they can't find the kills onto them.
Problem is,
LW, can they still hold?
What ultimates do they really have to push with? They have 7 seconds. They're guaranteed to hit overtime before they can get across this bridge, and Luxor Dread can just reset, regroup for a big attack here. All they have is the Whole Hog and the Nano Boost out of Unko. This is going to be so tough. They cannot leave this payload. Luxor Dread, they could win the match here. They could get to the Grand Finals.
Well, now Rogue has 3 ultimates available. Unko with the Nano Boost soon, as well with the Whole Hog. Skipjack, if he can land a massive Earth Shatter, this could be the tipping point for Rogue to make it to that second checkpoint. 5-man push, they're moving this thing along quite quickly. See if they can do it. Nanahana going low, trying to get a flank from the backside. See if he's able to do it. Janus coming in, almost has an Earth Shatter of his own. Self-destruct coming down, not going to find any targets, but they move off the payload. He's not able to tag it back in time. AKM couldn't make it, and that will be the victory coming in for LW Red. 3-1 over top of Rogue, knocking our last foreign team out of the tournament. And they will move on to face Lunatic High tomorrow in the Grand Final.
So Luxury Watch Purple, basically, here. I mean, they have one person from Luxury Watch Red, Nadohana, the rest from LW Blue, showing why they're in the Apex League and why they're a team that deserved to be here into the Grand Finals. This is going to be insane. Like, Rogue, they played really well. They tried some really wonky comms, Sova Healer, triple DPS, like quad tank, solo DPS, solo healer. I like to see them take this as an opportunity to test things out, kind of get their identity for the team, kind of figure out what works really well for them. And they proved a lot to us. They were able to take off a map against LW Red. They're able to do fairly well on some other maps. They're able to do a lot better in control than their counterpart Misfits. But still, you can't deny how strong LW Red and Sabi Olby, like this man, insane. Insane play out of him.
Yeah, absolutely crazy. I mean, it doesn't matter really what you put him on, whether it's the Roadhog, whether it's the Tracer. He is just constantly in your face and just landing those hooks. So a really strong performance from him, and he's going to need that as they get ready to go up against Lunatic High, because we saw just how strong they were looking against Afrika Blue. They are considered the end boss of Korean teams here.
Yeah.
So it's going to be a tall order for LW Red to take them down. But if they're able to do so, I said yesterday, I think LW Red could take this tournament. If they're able to do that, then they are a shoo-in to make it into Apex.
100%. I completely agree with you. I mean, They've improved so much. I think they kind of showed everyone out that they've been practicing the new meta, but also since Apex Season 1 kicked off and LW Red got put into the Challenger League and LW Blue got bumped up into the main league. But really, we heard Nanohana in the video say Sabi Olby, he's like their secret weapon. There's a lot of things he can do that they haven't shown just yet. And I still think we haven't seen it. I still think they're hiding an ace up their sleeve into these finals for tomorrow. And they're going to need it. Lunatic, fantastic, phenomenal team. I don't know if LW Red can beat them because of how flexible that they can be.
It's definitely going to be a tough one for them, but we'll have to wait until tomorrow to see if that is able to go down. Of course, that is going to be happening a little bit earlier than today's game, so
11 a.m. local time.
Off. Yeah, 11 a.m. here in Korea, which will be 6 p.m. Pacific. But we'll go ahead and take a couple look at the highlights, and this was soon popping off on that Genji, getting a couple kills. But Nanohana, I mean, his versatility as well, swapping back and forth between multiple characters, the Mei doing some work, and Janus with a really cheeky hole.
He's even able to escape off of that one and save the old. This is what we're showing before. Like, you group up in a tight area, and they're going to just completely demolish you. I don't know, but Sky, it was actually really nice to see out of both teams. When we made it into the second round of attack, we got to see some crazy compositions from both teams, some crazy positioning as well.
And this
is what we're talking about. This is like, how are you ever going to survive that one?
Yeah, and just another, you know, beautiful pulse bump from Sabi Olby. Really just knows exactly when to throw that to maximize the amount of kills that he could get, the amount of damage that he could get. And just, I mean, really strong stuff from both sides. This Rogue roster does look quite strong.
Yeah.
Despite the loss here today, I think that they can, you know, move forward into 2017 with high hopes for this one.
100%. Even Misfits. I mean, they've already been knocked out, but they have such a deep hero pool across the team. And funny enough, like, every single team that's come to this event to play has either had roster swaps or role swaps.
Yeah.
And I think we've seen some really good signs out of all teams. LW Red, like, I wouldn't be surprised to see this actually be, like, the new LW Red team. Or the new LW Blue team. Like, they are amazing.
Yeah, I mean, the unfortunate thing is that they have to do 3 starting members of LW Red as they move into the promotion tournament, so they can't
so
run
Pine
this
and
exact
awesome guy,
squad.
Nanohana.
Yeah, so they could run that. They could bring Sabi in if they really want to. I don't know how they're going to arrange things so they have a good balance of tank support and DPS. So we'll see what squad they want to run come next week. I'm not sure what day they're playing yet, but it will be sometime next week around the similar time as this tournament. But they look really strong, and I would not be surprised, as you said, once they make it into Apex, if they just go ahead and they mash these guys right back into LW Purple.
And I wonder if Lunatic High is actually going to pay attention to Sabe Gilby a little bit more, because on the Tracer,
oh, you have to.
He had so much free reign. We did see AKM like switch over to McCree there on Eichenwalde, and they was able to handle him, but for the most part, they didn't seem to really want to contest him like in a hard counter like McCree can offer. So maybe Eska, which he's been known to play a damn good McCree, even before this patch, I wonder if they could be a little bit more fluid in their changes.
I mean, quite possibly, but yeah, I think if there's any player really that you have to respect on this LW roster, it's going to be Sabe Gilby, and then right behind him is going to be Nanohana.
Yep.
So they really have to keep their eyes peeled on them. Definitely going to be looking out for Miro to try to jump on top of them with the Winston, just kind of melt them out, because he is the master of just destroying those 200 HP heroes with that Winston. So if Sabe Gilby is going to be playing that Tracer, you can be damn sure he's going to try to jump on top of him and take him out of the fight immediately.
I wonder what maps we have, because I know they're predetermined, but I didn't actually look at what Grand Final maps.
Yeah, I don't have them written down. I won't be casting the Grand Final. It'll be you guys, as D-Man and Uber joining you on a TriCast. I have League of Legends to worry about, but I am also interested to be watching that tomorrow. But just a recap here for today. Afrika Freaks Blue going down in a 1-3 loss over Lunatic High. They advance into the final. They'll be playing against LW Red, who also had a 3-1 victory over Rogue. So Rogue, unfortunately, not going to be representing the West in the finals here. But we'll be seeing those tomorrow, and it's going to be one hell of a game, that's for sure.
I'm actually curious what your thoughts on AF Blue were, because they changed two players specifically to deal with their lack of a deep hero pool across the team, because Arhan, for instance, was playing D.Va at the Apex Finals.
Yeah.
And they still didn't really play D.Va, at least in the first map from Watchpoint Gibraltar.
And that was the big problem when it came to Afrika Freaks Blue in the Apex Finals, was that they didn't run D.Va for a lot of it. They finally swapped when we saw Arhan go to the Zarya instead of the D.Va, whereas you look at an Envious and they were just running D.Va every single game with Mickey. So it's just a must-have on pretty much any map. There's very few maps you can get away with not having that D.Va. But again, a best of five tomorrow. Lunatic High versus LW Red. A winner will be our champion here at IEM Gyeonggi. And this will be a very strong showing for both of these guys. Lunatic High looking to bounce back after their loss in the semifinals of Apex League. LW Red, of course, not making it into Apex League, so they definitely want to have a strong showing.
I want to push you for a prediction on this. So you won't be here tomorrow to see or to cast it. I want to know, how do you think this one's going to go, and what kind of map score?
It is so tough to call, honestly, but I'm gonna be devil's advocate. I'm going to give this to LW Red, but it's going to go full five maps.
So you think if LW Red win, it's going to have to go five.
Yes.
But if Lunatic High wins, it's going to be 3-1?
Yes. I will say a 3-1.
I get behind you on that, 100%.
All right. In case you guys didn't watch the rest of our games here at Gyeonggi today, Pongdu Monster had a 2-1 victory over Immortals, also knocking out the last remaining Western team from the League of Legends tournament. So they move on to face Samsung Galaxy tomorrow in a best of five set. And then Stats was able to take out Buell in StarCraft 2 in a 3-2 victory. Yeah. So we had some longer series today. No, not so much the 3-0s and the 2-0s.
And Stats actually came back and won that one from being down in the series and kind of surprised quite a few people. I think he's playing against Innovation tomorrow. It's an all Korean final in StarCraft as well. And of course, you can now see.
That one's
right,
almost always a game.
There we go. So you can see what matches we'll have for you coming up tomorrow, starting at 11 a.m. Korean time.
Yeah, so we are shuffling around the schedule a little bit. StarCraft 2 still in the same locked off slot there as far as times go, but Overwatch will be kicking off the day at 11 a.m. Korean Standard Time. Again, that is 6 p.m. Pacific. And that is 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
Really good.
And we'll be closing out the day. I have to. I have a lot of people back home that I need to talk to. But, of course, League of Legends will be closing out the day as well. So it'll be a lot of exciting matchups. So hopefully you guys can join us for all of the esports that we have here at IEM Gyeonggi tomorrow.
Yeah, I can't wait to see. I'm actually really happy to see Overwatch at the Intel Extreme Masters. It's something I've been hoping for quite a while. And I was glad we can kind of sneak it into this one and to see some of the Western teams that have had all these different switches within their teams, the three-way swap that we have happen, and see kind of what they bring to the table now. But this just makes me more excited for Apex Season 2 to see these Korean teams play like this. It's amazing.
It's going to be absolutely insane. We also have to see what foreign teams are going to be coming out to Apex, because you have to imagine that Envious will be there, try to retain their title, that second season. So we'll see if they're able to do that. But I mean, all of the games that we're going to have tomorrow are going to be really exciting. Samsung Galaxy versus Pongdu Monster. It'll be a really strong showing. But that's going to be it from us here today. We'll see you guys tomorrow for the Grand Final.